He has been victimized by an incompetent Justice Department led temporarily by Rod Rosenstein, who I think is a disgrace.
That is former U.S. Attorney for the District of Columbia and President Trump legal advisor Joe DiGenova with our colleague Brian Niemann this morning.
He's
back. Doesn't mince words for Rod Rosenstein. He told Brian today that he is not the president's lawyer, nor is his wife. That's because of a conflict of interest. He represented some other folks involved in the probe. He wouldn't name those people. But he has had Joe DiGenova a about face on Rod Rosenstein because
I
remember
180 degrees.
Yeah, 180 degrees. Because I remember when Jeff Sessions named Rod Rosenstein. Rod Rosenstein was nominated as
great
deputy attorney general. It was a great pick.
Not just that, Robert. When it comes to the issue of Robert Mueller, it was the same former U.S. attorney Joe DiGenova who thought that Robert Mueller was a fantastic selection for special counsel. Even though Joe DiGenova disagreed with the creation of the special counsel looking into the Russia potential Trump campaign and overall Russia in fusion in the 2016 presidential election, these were people of integrity. Now, though, that this investigation has been elongated and it appears to be getting close to the 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. Now, Joe DiGenova, let's just say he has a certain...
And this is after he had a conversation, Victoria, had several conversations with the president.
Right.
He's very impressed with the president. You can hear all this on
He sounds like a fan
WBAL.
To me. I'm saying as Robert Lang is and saying he's like a fan
he's
of
a
The
fan.
Apprentice.
Yes,
okay.
Well, he's a fan of The Apprentice.
Yes.
So I guess Mr. DiGenova's about face is, could we read something into the fact that Robert Mueller
is getting closer.
Is getting close.
I truly believe that. I've said from the very beginning of this investigation, Robert, when it comes to the attorneys, the U.S. attorneys that Robert Mueller brought on board, they are all in the financial fraud, money laundering type of expertise field. That the bigger issue other than the 2016 involvement in the elections of Russia could have been financial laundering issues. You look at Jared Kushner and the investigation looking into in reference to his Deutsche Bank relationships and also the Trump enterprises in terms of some of their relationships with Russia. I believe is heading down that road, not necessarily down the road of going after President Trump politically.
Is there a sense that President Trump might say to protect his business and protect his business interests, I don't want to be president anymore.
He
I
could.
Would resign.
He could, but I don't think we got to go there. I don't believe that it's going to get to that degree and that level. I truly believe, Robert, that when it comes to the issue of Manafort, of Gates, who've already pled guilty to certain things, that whatever information they're sharing with Robert Mueller is going to lead to, I believe, the son-in-law of the president and some of the issues he was involved with. And I believe that they're going to have to leave the White House. I think that Jared Kushner and Ivanka are going to have to leave their roles
There's
in the White House.
There's already speculation that he's going to do that, and he's going to go work for the campaign.
Well, he lost his security.
He lost his security clearance.
Exactly. So, I mean, right now he's just playing an advisor to his father-in-law at this point.
And what do you make of the tweeting this weekend?
Oh, very interesting. It started off with a happy Easter, Robert.
Yeah,
And devolved into an attack on Mexico, into the post office. I don't know where that one came from. Into no DACA deal.
Right.
President Donald Trump, when he goes away to Mar-a-Lago and nobody is there to help him, he kind of gets onto Fox News and starts tweeting up a storm. Like today, he just had another tweet with a very bespeckled Easter bunny that was kind of weird, Robert. I don't know about the Easter bunny with glasses.
The Easter bunny with glasses, but he also talked
with
economy,
Melania, but on with Melania and the president. Look, the president at times needs to put the phone away, and even as close to the advisors, say the same thing.
But he won't listen to his
No,
advisors.
He's not going to listen. He's going to tweet storms like we just saw. By the way, the post office tweet was inaccurate with Amazon and a bunch of other things.
All right, C4, the encore tonight at midnight. Back
Thank
9
you,
to 1 tomorrow on WBAL News Radio 1090.